everybody.
Whoa, good morning.
Welcome to Wake Up Missoula.
Welcome to Wake Up Missoula. We were playing the video from last time, sorry about that. All right.
Oops.
So let's move on. I forgive you. Do you forgive me?
Yes. I hope you all had a good weekend.
Yep.
It is now Monday morning.
It is pretty cold. It was cold. I woke up cold this morning, and I was kind of happy about it.
It's supposed to be like in the 90s all week, though.
Oh, no.
It's kind of nice. Oh, no.
Because we're going to be outside for movie making camp this Wednesday.
I know, it's
going to be hot. So, yeah, Movie Making Club is happening.
Movie Making
this week.
Camp, yes.
And we are, like, not only full, but we have, I think we have way too many kids.
Really? How
yeah.
many do you have?
I honestly, 17? We have, definitely we have 12, because wow. that's the cutoff, that's a cap. It's like, no. And then there's, like, a couple of people just like, well, I paid for it, and it's like, well, you signed up 3 days, like, 5 days ago.
Oh.
And it's like, you can't do that, that's not fair.
Really?
It's like, well, we already said it was kind of full. But anyways, I digress, so the best thing we'll probably have to do is just be like, hey, listen, we'll put them on a waiting list, and if, you know, yeah.
Sorry. Oops.
But yeah, that's the big stress of the week. Of course, if you take a look at our
webcam,
that's moving
what's
at
happening
a
on the corner
high resolution of 15 frames per second.
Higgins and what's that spruce right there?
Yep, if you're up right now, this is the perfect time to go for a run, go for a walk before it gets extremely hot, because today is going to be mostly sunny.
High of 94 today.
Low of 57. Tuesday is going to be another 94. And then Wednesday, there's going to be a chance of thunderstorms, 91. But of course, there's only a 20% chance of that anyways. 86, and then it'll start cooling off by the end of the week. Hopefully by the weekend you can expect to be warm, but not extremely hot, but you know, it's not Arizona.
Yeah, thank goodness.
Thank goodness.
Thank gosh we don't get like 110 degree weather here. That would just like be hardcore.
Yep. So as I said before, we just got a Twitter page, so it's @WakeUpMissoula. Pretty straightforward, and also we have a Facebook page, right? Yeah, I think it's quite amazing. And if you guys were looking for last Friday's show, I'm sorry, it wasn't available because if you think about it, if we exceed, like, for some reason, so I'm just talking through my butt right now, but
no, go for it.
But my theory is that if we exceed over 57.56 minutes over the allotted time. So, like, if we do the full entire show for the full entire hour, therefore, it cannot be posted online. It fails every time.
Oh,
it
that's
just
so
has been
weird.
Failing. There's one show I just kind of gave up on it a while ago.
What about putting it on YouTube first?
That could be true. I mean, I put it onto our Final Cut program that we use for our all our shows and music and all that stuff. I have uploaded directly to YouTube as the video file, and that's sometimes worked, sometimes hasn't worked. But when you're dealing with a big data file, it's just like, you can't exceed a certain amount of data to be uploaded to YouTube, even if it is only less than 500 megabytes. So for you geeks out there.
Yeah.
But anyways, first thing I do want to show is a little PSA that our very own Mr. Christian Ackerman made, and it's about our channel change by the end of August. So check it out.
Doc, what's up,
Mark? It's MCAT. When you see MCAT channel 711 change the channels 189 to 190, you're gonna see some serious.
Doc, are you telling me that MCAT channel 711 is gonna be channel 189 and 190?
Precisely.
That's heavy.
Great Scott! When light!
Ah! Yep, there it is.
Oh, man. Too funny.
Yep.
Good job.
And then I'll show the other one a little bit later. But
okay.
For right now, I'm going to talk about a little thing called Megs. And it's all about fun, having fun with Megs. And
it's all about having fun with Megs.
Media assistance grants. And they're great for
everything. But
and
maybe
it provides any organization that is a nonprofit to get their voice heard on a program that is known as Missoula Community Access Television. And we do a lot of lectures, we've done a lot of musical events, all the stuff that happens in Missoula. And we have over 800 nonprofits in Missoula to look into.
So yeah.
That's just a lot of nonprofits.
Oh my God, so many. We've hit like 600, right?
Yeah, 600.
We have 200 left. We so kinda, give us a call.
We're spreading.
Have an event.
We're spreading. So the first one is about the Mullen Road Conference, and this is part three. And it's going to be on tonight at 3 p.m., followed by...
Is this part three of three?
I don't know what part of which it is, but they're going to be talking about it at 7 p.m. tonight. And then followed by that is the... Let's see, the Missoula County Democrats.
Ooh.
And they're talking about the League of Women Voters and some. I'll let you listen. It's pretty dope. Right, here we go. Oh, there we go.
Yesterday, people from my community went out and dug bitterroot. A young girl dug the first plant, and people prayed, like we have done for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years.
And that's going to be at 7 p.m. on MCAT. And then the next day, exactly 24 hours from there, is this.
One little piece to keep an eye on is our lobbying laws are actually quite, like our campaign finance laws, are quite broad. But they have been pulled back a little bit in practice over time. And this hasn't been Commissioner Modell's main focus.
Proud to be the principal sponsor of the legislation that established same-day voter registration in 2005. My colleague Diane Sands was my principal staff person, and we worked long and hard during that legislative session to get this passed.
And that's what you can expect for 7 p.m. tonight and tomorrow. But of course,
oh, yes.
In terms of programming, there's going to be all the graduations from May and June, because that's when
high school graduations,
and that's going to be on tonight at all night. It's going to be sandwiching the city council meeting.
So
it's going to be on tonight on channel 11, not channel 7. It's going to be on channel 11. So it's going to be 4 p.m. It's going to be Willard. 5:10 is going to be Hellgate. And then there's going to be the city council meeting. And let's see. I'm going to put it to our website real quick. And here you go. This is where you can see all the information on our website, MCAT.org, about all the time. So I'm going to read them off real quick. As you can see them on the screen, it's going to be 4 p.m. Willard. Hellgate is 5:10 p.m. Sentinel is 9 p.m. Big Sky is 10:15. And Sea Lake is last, not least, at 11:30 p.m.
11:30. Cool.
A lot of great stuff.
Yeah, you guys can just have like a graduation-a-thon.
Yep. Relive those memories with graduation.
Yeah, relive those memories. Man, I wish my high school graduation was recorded. Yeah. I wish I also did something crazy, but I didn't.
And also City Band is this week. And speaking of City Band, they also played a song by the same guy who made that Pop'em Circumstance.
Oh.
So, yeah, I know. Yeah. It actually was pretty fun to play rather than... I want to grow up and leave.
How often do you play in the City Band?
I guess every week, but I missed 1 week a couple weeks ago because I was there for the Bonner Milltown Community Council.
Oh, yeah, you had to film it.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah. What do you play?
I play trombone.
Cool. Do you have band buddies?
I do have band buddies.
This is fun.
There's a huge difference between a band nerd and a band geek, and I would probably be band geek.
What's the difference?
A band nerd plays music to make money.
Ladies? Oh.
And band geek, it tries to impress the ladies. Hey, how's it going?
Hey, I'm in the city band.
I'm playing flute.
I do interpretive dancing in the city band. I'm kidding.
All right. Oh, there was something else I wanted to say. Oh, yeah. I wanted to show one more video, and it was about... Actually, I queued it up on here as one of the videos that... let me try to set it up. And it's called El Diali.
Oh, El Diali.
One of the videos that...
one of the girls made. This is
me, you, and the... two little girls that were in our camp from last week all made this movie. They brought their Barbies. So I played Barbies.
It was a bunch of fun.
Hashtag Barbies. Hashtag shame. Hashtag.
Hashtag fun.
Hashtag fun.
Hashtag he loves it.
I want to do it all the time.
Barbies are great. Yeah. They're great. We should have. I wish we had made our own stuff. Animation video.
Oh, yeah.
We'll have to get some. Find some Barbies, we'll do it.
You wanted me to film, like, you guys just playing Barbies and just pretending to talk to each other?
Yeah.
You had this huge conversation with Matthew as Barbies, and he was totally down for it, too.
I know.
It's like, Matthew's, like, one of the funniest, greatest kids
and ever. He's awesome. He's seriously sweet. He's awesome. And today's his birthday.
Today is his birthday.
Happy 13th birthday, Matthew. Yeah.
So, like, today he's going to come down. Like, he's 13, so he's a teenager. So he's going to come here. He's going to wear all black. And just have his hair in his face. And
so
like, how'd you grow your hair so fast? It's like, because I'm that angsty.
Yeah. Before his birthday, he was like, all right, in 3 days, I'm going to be an angsty teen, and I'm not going to like anything.
I think that's probably my fault, because I put those words in his mouth.
Yeah.
I'm teaching these kids all sorts of wrong things.
God, it's so funny. He's seriously like one of the best kids ever.
But
he's great.
The main focus of this camp is we're all going to combine our talents and make a big movie.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll have him do music because he's a great pianist. Mm-hmm. So, man, we've been giving compliments all day because it's his birthday.
Oh, man.
So
it is his birthday. He deserves those compliments. I hope people give me compliments on my birthday.
Good job for getting another year older. Or good job for another living another year. But that's enough of this. I'm going to show Al Di Ali.
That's enough of this.
Everybody. Hey, I want to play.
Hey, everyone, I'm sorry.
Oh, and this is what happened. I'm so lonely. Play with me.
So the monsters did it.
Pink is my favorite color. Hi. Bye.
Credits!
Noel McAvoy! Scott Rand!
This is the end of the movie! This is the end of the alley!
All right, there it was.
Right? How cute is that? Oh, man, those kids are funny.
It's, like, disgustingly adorable.
I know, it's
too
adorable.
Of course. Let's see. Do we have any other...
I think, no.
Do you want to go into...
Events?
So let's go to a PSA that our very own Matthew Knight, the birthday boy, made the other day. And then we'll go straight into events, and then maybe I'll think of a couple of things else to say, because...
Or
maybe not. I mean, we'll just shut up the rest of the show.
Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? Hashtag shut up.
Hashtag don't know.
Hashtag, there's too many hashtags. I'm not going to write it all down.
Hashtag.
Yep.
Oh, hey. We didn't notice you there. Say, we're at an MCAT camp right now. And over the past summer, we've had many of them. So many that I can't keep track. And during these camps, we've had groups making movies all day long. It's a really great thing. And you could sign your child up today. The thing is, MCAT camps are amazing and fun, and everyone loves them. So if you're thinking of camps to put your child in this summer to get them away from you, choose MCAT, because we know what we're doing, I think. And everything it's just spectacular. Here I am, cat. Here I am, cat. Everything is cool. Here I am, cat. Here I am, cat. Everything is cool with the K.
Oh, that's not it. There we go.
Oh, man. He's too funny.
I got it on autoplay over here, so I just kept playing all the videos that we have in our roster.
Happy birthday, Matthew.
Happy birthday. And just so you know, we can't sign up any kids. Don't sign up any kids.
Don't sign up anywhere.
We're already full.
We're done.
We have enough kids already.
We have like 30.
All right, so I'll stop talking.
Events with Noel. Okay, Monday events. So there is a MISMO summer camp, sports camp today at MISMO Gymnastics. It started at 8:30, but I'm sure that you could be a little late. So this will be July 28th to August 1st. For a full week, full day, you know, like 9 to 4, for members, 150, non-members, 165, and the half day is for members, 95, and non-members, 105. And then just for like a day, just for a full day, if you're a member, it's $35. And for a half day, if you're a member, it's $25. And then $5 more each, so like $40, $30 if you're non-members. And then Tuesday and Thursday, they're afternoon field trips. Friday, there's a show and snow cones. And there's a half day every Friday. And they'll just do arts and crafts, gymnastics, and have a bunch of fun and make new friends.
Art-nastics
and some fun. So visit their website or call 728-0908 for more information or to sign up. There at the Zootown Arts Community Center, there's papier-mâché pets and other creatures. This will be from July 28th to August 1st, 9 a.m. to noon. For students age 6 through 12, it's $90 for non-members or $80 for members. And in this class, the students will just create animal sculptures out of papier-mâché. And, you know, discuss design and structure and create a 3D dimensional sculpture out of papier-mâché. And just have a lot of fun. And also make new friends. And they'll be able to paint them, too. Yeah. So that's what's going on at the ZAC. At the Missoula Art Museum at 9 a.m., there is Making Your Mark with Multiples. This is from 9 a.m. to 12, ages 10 to 14, $63 or $70 if you're a member. And so they're going to explore four different types of printmaking processes: monoprinting, calligraph printing, relief printing, and cyanotypes or sun printing. They'll print by hand and also using MAM's etching press. So that'll be kind of cool. It's like a printmaking class. So you'll just learn how to printmake and learn texture and color and all the different machines and designs. And yeah, kind of do like an Andy Warhol thing. That'll be fun.
Nice.
There is a Coach Shane's Super Awesome Fun and Games Camp. It's at 9 a.m. at the Peaceful Heart Yoga Studio located in the Warehouse Mall. So this is just a week of nothing but fun and games. The special focus will be on turning everyday items around your house into awesome fun games so that summertime boredom will be a thing of the past.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So here's some of the games that they'll be playing. Hop the Mighty Skip Jammer, Crazy Hopscotch, Human Quidditch. Oh,
I play that.
Mega Ultra Ball, and a Huckle Buckle Beanstalk. What's Human Quidditch like?
Oh, wait, no, it's Human Quad Ball. Never mind. Oh. Quidditch, that's like Harry Potter.
Yeah. I'm reading Harry Potter right now.
I'm rereading.
Oh, yeah, I'm rereading the series.
Is it rereading?
Oh, it's like rereading. I grew up with those books.
Oh, me too. I was 11 when Harry Potter was 11 in the books and in the movies. Well, we all grew up with the actors from Harry Potter.
Yeah, that's true.
It's like they were the same age as us. So it's kind of weird because it's like you think of them as kids.
Yeah.
And you see the first movie, it's like, wow, he's a tiny little thing.
Yeah, and now he's like all
grown
adult
up and
foxy.
Doing weird movies now.
Yeah,
he's doing a lot of indie movies.
He has
The Woman in Black, and then there's a movie where he's doing horns, has horns on his head for some reason. I don't know.
Oh, that's weird.
That is weird. Yeah,
huh. All right. Well, I was in first grade when the first book came out.
I was.
So I just like ate it up. I was super nerdy. I think I was in fourth or third or fourth grade.
I can't remember. I never read the books.
When I was a little girl, I was super nerdy. I like had huge glasses, and I had ADHD, and so I was just like, yeah. Can you imagine me as like a little kid?
Yeah.
It was pretty ridiculous. So I read a lot, and I loved Harry Potter. Me and Harry have been dating since I was like 8. Oh, okay, sorry. Back to this awesome, fun camp. Okay, so this will be 9 to 4, Monday through Friday, and it's $100. And there's optional before and after childcare. There is Hellgate Cheerleading Kids Camp at Hellgate High School today, July 28th from 9:45 a.m. to 3. And then there'll be instruction for their 6:30 performance. They're going to perform at the Osprey game after cheerleading camp today. It'll cost $40 and includes instruction in basic cheerleading skills from the Hellgate cheerleaders, lunch, and a t-shirt, a cheer bow, and two Osprey tickets. And so for more information or to register, please email Tony Malik, tony.malik.tm.
Oh, I went to high school with her.
Com. Oh, did you?
Yeah, she went to Big Sky.
Cool. So Tony, tony.malik.tm@gmail.com.
She's been doing it for a couple of years, so she has good experience.
That's good.
I recommend it if you
have little cheerleaders.
Yeah. Or aspiring cheerleaders.
Aspiring cheerleaders.
Aspiring.
I'm an aspiring cheerleader.
I'm aspiring. Hashtag.
Aspiring cheerleader. All right. Therapeutic Yoga for Wellness. This is Mondays from noon to 1. It's an ongoing class. You can join anytime. It's at the Learning Center at Red Willow. It's $40 for 6 weeks or $9 for drop-in. It's just filled with restorative and gentle yoga stretches, breathwork, guided meditation, and deep relaxation techniques that help promote physical healing, balance the nervous center, and deepen the sense of inner peace and well-being. It's good for those with anxiety, chronic fatigue syndrome, and other illnesses and injuries. At the Zootown Arts Community Center today at 1, there is a class on cartooning. This will be from July 28th to August 1st, in the afternoons from 1 to 4. It's for ages 6 through 12. It's $90 for non-members and $80 for members. And you just learn about cartooning. They'll talk about cartoons, drawing cartoons. They'll learn different styles and techniques and, like, you know, do different colors. And they'll be working with a bunch of different sorts of medias. So you can learn how to cartoon. That would be cool. At the Roots Sport and Learning Center, there's a hip-hop dance camp. It's at 1 p.m. today. And you learn new skills, make new friends, and develop your creative abilities. So it's for ages 6 to 12. You can do half-day camps or full-day camps. And so you can do, for a half-day, it's 1 to 4, and that's for the whole week. $99, and then full day for 1 to 4 is, or from the, okay, sorry, for the full day from 9 a.m. to 4 is $179. And then there is a one-time $10 camp registration fee for camper, and then there's a non-refundable $45 deposit that's required to secure your spot in the camp, but that goes towards your tuition. So that'll be okay. There is a Raspberry Pi project. This is at 3:30 at the Missoula Public Library. Mm-hmm.
And it's Pi as in P-I, not... Oh, is it like actual pies?
I'm not sure. Oh, I don't think so. No, it's Pi
the
as
pie
in like
sign?
3 point... Yeah. Yeah. Because they're... It's called Marker Space Raspberry Pi Projects. And you can just go to the library and work on various projects. And you'll learn how to use... electronics, the Raspberry Pi, and the Python, which I have no idea what those are.
I know the math majors at the university celebrate National Pi Day 3/14.
Oh yeah, I'm sure they do. I'm sure. So that's every Monday from 3:30 to 6. There is a little show at Ear Candy that'll be today at 4 p.m. There's a band called Electrician. They're from Oakland, and they're just going to be playing a special in-store performance. It's going to go on from 4 to 5 at Ear Candy. And if you want to find out what they sound like, you can go to Facebook or YouTube and type in Electrician. Wow. They're from Oakland, California.
California.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Oh, and they'll also be playing tonight at the Zach. So, yeah, check it out. At the Learning Center at Red Willow, there is the Collective's Movements in Individual Development and Trauma. It's at 6:30 p.m. And so this is just about, I'll read you what the event page says, because it's kind of interesting. So it says, we live among and within many collectives. We read about or are involved in mass movements, and yet we are individuals. Does this introduce conflicts and misunderstandings? Individual and collective developments are naturally occurring life experiences. Both conscious and unconscious influences orchestrate these developments. However, the latter is more influential than most of us realize. Mass movements are special forms of collectives which can promote positive or negative results. Often, a leader or individuals making up these movements have been affected by trauma. How mass movements and the individuals sustaining them are affected is critical to the course. So that's kind of interesting. Yeah, check that out. That's going to be neat. Missoula Osprey versus the Great Falls Voyagers is today at 7 p.m. It's at the, you know, Allegiance Field, the Osprey Field, tonight. 7 p.m. and the Hellgate High School cheerleading cheer camp will be cheering there. And so it's family night, so you can get 4 tickets. And with that, you'll get 4 hot dogs, sodas, bags of chips and one super score card for $30. Yeah. Cool. Oh, and then all military members retired or actively serving will receive $5 reserve tickets with military identification. Nice. At the Top Hat Lounge tonight, there's movie night with Charles Bradley. Charles Bradley, Soul of America is what his movie is called, and I've got the trailer for it. This guy's actually coming to Missoula on Thursday night. Yeah. So they're showing his movie tonight, and then he'll be at the Top Hat on Thursday.
Wow.
Night. Yeah. So here's his trailer.
I don't know how many artists have ever been 62 years old and released their debut record. He may be the first.
It's hard enough for people in their mid-20s to launch a career. Someone in their 60s, it's almost insane.
One morning, and I think it was pretty early, it was like 9 or 10 in the morning, I got a knock on my door. It was Charles. He said, I heard you were looking for singers.
I've been playing James Brown since I was 14 years old, but now I want to do Charles Bradley.
My first album is coming out January 25th.
Why is it so hard?
The new music for once is me. It's things that I have experienced, that have went through, heartaches and pains. And hurt.
He's lived a life where terrible things have happened to him.
I was sick as a dog. I was close to death.
And he's lived under harsh conditions.
I was 14 years old. My home was the subway train.
And he still has this optimism about him. He just feels in his heart that everything is going to be good.
Most people could have just given up and, you know, not done anything. And, you know, he's just been plugging away doing music forever.
I never made enough money to support myself in music. But I'm hoping that this album will make a turning point for me. Tonight is the night of my album release. Is the night that I truly find, do I keep going? Do I have it?
They got me in the post on page 6. Oh.
I'm sitting over here talking to you in the paper?
My Lord.
Wow. Wow, sold out.
But this love that I feel around me will make me reach in my heart and give everybody a little piece.
We gotta make a change.
Wow. Sweet, right?
That's an intense trailer.
I know, it was cool. Yeah, so he'll be here on Thursday night at 8 p.m. at the Top Hat. I don't know how much his tickets are. Let's see, I can find out.
The Top Hat, it's usually ranges from like $15 to $25.
Yeah.
Oh,
it says,
cool.
It says 15 to 17. So you can watch his movie and then see him on Thursday. That's cool.
And the movie's free?
Yeah, oh yeah, it's... Top Hat has movies like almost every Monday night. They're always free.
Great.
Yeah, all ages. Free show starts at 8 p.m. Yeah, check it out. Okay, so that's what's going on Monday. And now this is what is happening on Tuesday. So the Good Food Store is having a cooking school camp. It's at 10 a.m. tomorrow, where they'll learn basic cooking skills, as well as, you know, having hands-on lessons supplemented with discussions about health, nutrition, and food and kitchen safety. This year's Camp I Can Cook sessions will consist of 4 days of instruction, all with classes taught by, you know, the Good Food Store cooking staff and deli and, you know, people who work there. All classes will be 2.5 hours long, and at the end of each day, everyone that cooks will be able to eat, you know, what they made. And each one will get an apron. Cool.
I would kind of like in my mind, I imagine, like, it's like, I can see one of the teachers is like, hey, listen, like, I'm going to make you like vegetables, and this is how I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
And that's how they should do it. I mean, like, that's a great, like, it's teaching kids how to eat healthy and just like, hey, I can make broccoli taste amazing.
Yeah, it's true.
Hey, I can make broccoli taste amazing. I can teach that class. It's like, hey, put a lot of sugar on it.
Yeah, put some cheese on it. Yeah.
Fondue.
So then, and then a part of this camp, they're having a teen Chopped, which I don't know if you... ever have seen the show Chopped, but it's where, like, they have these three chefs and then they give them are a bunch of random ingredients, and they have to make the best dish out of the ingredients.
Reality show.
Yeah. So this session is for ages 14 to 16. It'll be Tuesday through Friday, July 29th to August 1st. This will be from 10 a.m. to 12:30. This one is $100. And yeah, they'll just give them random ingredients and expect them to make something awesome out of it. And they'll bring in judges. Bam. So they'll judge you.
Bam.
Yeah. So call a good food store if you want to know more information about that. 541-3663. There is Kids Fest tomorrow at 10:30 a.m. at Karis Park. This will be a fun-filled afternoon for kids and kids at heart. They'll just have a lot of, you know, probably a lot of fun stuff for kids. That's what I imagine Kids Fest would be. Also at the Missoula Public Library, there's another Makerspace Open Time Project Development where they give open time to allow visitors to explore the resources of Makerspace, where they can learn how to use some of the equipment and work on a specific project. So what I'm going to guess is Makerspace is this place in the library where you can work on electronic projects and like computer stuff. So that's cool. It's from 1 to 5 tomorrow. 4 p.m. there's a second annual tribute to Fallen Soldiers Memorial Run. This is put on by Grizzly Harley Davidson. So it'll be from the Grizzly Harley Davidson to the Old Beck VFW. So it'll be Torch Run riders and special guests. So I'm going to guess there's going to be people running and the people with their riding on their motorcycles. And this is a tribute to the Fallen Soldiers. That's nice. Yeah, that'll be tomorrow at 4 p.m. Also on Tuesdays, there's a Missoula Farmers Market, 5:30 at Circle Square. It's every Tuesday from July 8th through September 23rd, and it's from 5:30 to 7 p.m. And they also have the one on Saturdays, which is at the Red X's from 8 to 1. You know, and then the People's Market is 9 to 2, and then Karis Park, the Clark Fork, is from 8 to 1 as well. And my last event for tomorrow night is a picking circle at the Top Hat. Every Tuesday from 6 to 8, bluegrass-oriented musicians are invited down to go to the Top Hat and jam on the raised seating area in front of the sound booth. And it's free and for all ages. And that's what's going on today and tomorrow.
Cool. Yeah. Okay, so now that I remember something to talk about in show, I want to show that last PSA for our new channel.
Cool.
But here it is.
It has changed. Where is MCAT channel 7 and 11?
Batman, that's why I called you here. MCAT's changing their channels to 189 and 190.
Are you joking me?
No, I'm Commissioner Gordon. The Joker jokes.
We've been banished from the other channels.
No, we're just moving to channels 189 to 190.
Do you have a cough drop?
Yeah, maybe I can summon. Think Batman?
Yep, there was. Oh, that's on autoplay. Oh, it's on a playlist. That's right. Oh. Anyways, that's my own.
That's funny.
All right, so I think we can end our show.
Yeah, I think that's it.
We had a lot of stuff to talk about. I just want to show our website just one more time. If you look at our Facebook page.
Cute.
Here's our
Facebook page. We also have a Twitter.
I'm not going to show that because it looks pretty much like a carbon copy of our Facebook page.
MCAT is changing channels, 189 to 190. Oh, also, one last time. High school graduations, times has changed. Willard is at 4 p.m. Hellgate is at 5:10. Sentinel is at 9 p.m. Big Sky is at 10:15. And Sealy Lake is at 11:30. And all tonight on channel 11. So, sorry about that.
Yep.
Yeah. And that's
And City Council's tonight.
Yeah, City Council. Josh will be back on Wednesday to
talk all about it. And he has a video from Celtic Festival from last weekend.
Yeah,
We had the Dubliners.
You got to interview the Gothard sisters.
The Gothard sisters. Not to be confused with the Gothic sisters. Because they're like the polar opposite of the Gothic sisters. Because I saw the interview. I was like, oh, wow, they're not Gothic.
No, they're not Gothic at all. Yeah.
And there's the our Missoula's very own Dragon Pipe Band.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Sweet, yeah. I wish I had. Did you get to go to Celtic Fest besides working?
But working for Celtic Fest, so it was both. I got paid to go, so.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Cool.
And I filmed it, and it'll be on MCAT in 2-5 months.
Yeah. In the winter.
Because most
of
our programming
is... You can all reminisce about Celtic Fest in January.
Yeah. So, for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Renf.
I'm Noelle McCoy. See you Wednesday.
TTYL.